Hi there. Now in this video, what I want to do is show you how we go about finding the shortest distance from a point to a line. And the best way I can do this is to go through a typical example. Here we've got a line L that has this vector equation, and the point A has this position vector 3i plus 2j plus 4k. And we've got to find the shortest distance then of the point A from L. So what I've encouraged you to do is to draw a sketch first of all. And this would be my line L. We've got the origin, which you can mark anywhere, we'll just say it's there. And we've got the point A with this position vector. So I'll put A again anywhere, we'll just put it over here. And its coordinates will be 3, 2, 4. Now, when it comes to working out the shortest distance of A to L, it's going to be this perpendicular distance. So if I just mark that in with a right angle there, and let's say this point here on the line L is the point P. So we're trying to find out this length A to P. Now the position vector of P is given by R for some value of lambda that we've got here. Now, this part of the equation of the line, remember, represents a vector parallel to the line. And we're going to be using that in this particular type of question. So I'm just going to mark it in, and we'll mark its components in, minus 2, 1, and minus 2. All right. So how do we go about finding this shortest distance? Well, what I'm going to do is, first of all, work out what the vector A to P is, and that will be in terms of lambda. Then I'm going to use the scalar product or dot product between AP and this vector here. We know they're perpendicular to one another, so the scalar product will be zero, and that will allow me to build an equation and work out what lambda is. So then I'll be able to work out the vector AP. And from that, I'll be able to work out its magnitude and therefore that shortest distance. So that's where I'm going with this question. So let's start by working out what the vector AP is in terms of lambda. So A to P is going to be O to P minus O to A. Standard result there. And if we work this out in column vectors, O to P is given by this vector R, okay, for some value of lambda. So if I just group up the I components, the J components, and the K components, then I'm going to get for the I components 4 minus 2 lambda. And if I do the J components, I get minus 8 plus lambda. And then for the K components, I get 7 minus 2 lambda. And from this, we need to subtract the vector O to A, the position vector of A, which is 3, 2, 4. So we just put that in, 3, 2, 4. And when we simplify this, we've got 4 minus the 3 gives us 1, and then we've got minus 2 lambda. And for the other answers, you're going to get minus 10 plus lambda. And finally, the K components comes out at 3 minus 2 lambda. So there's the vector A to P in terms of lambda. And we're going to come back to that later. So I'm going to call that equation 1. So we know now that A to P is perpendicular to this vector here. So I can dot these two vectors together and it should equal 0. So I'll just write a note up here that therefore since the vector minus 2, 1, minus 2, if we were to dot it with the vector A to P, it must equal 0. So doing the dot product between this vector and this vector would have minus 2 times 1 minus 2 lambda. So minus 2 times 1 minus 2 lambda. And then we've got plus 1 times minus 10 plus lambda. And then finally, the minus 2 times 3 minus 2 lambda. And that's going to equal 0. Okay. Now we just need to expand the bracket. And if we do that, we're going to get minus 2 plus 4 lambda. And then minus 10 plus lambda. And then finally, minus 6 plus 4 lambda. And that's going to equal 0. Grouping up the lambda terms, we end up with 9 lambda. The constants come to minus 18. But if I add 18 to both sides, then I get 9 lambda equals 18. And from this, clearly, lambda equals 2. So, now that I've got lambda equals 2, I can substitute lambda equals 2 into 1. All right? And that will give me A to P. So, A to P, if we put lambda equals 2 in here, we've got 1 minus 4. That gives us minus 3. And doing it for the other components, we get minus 8 and minus 1. So, from this, we can get the magnitude of the vector AP, and that will give us our shortest distance. And in the usual way, this will be the square root of the sum of the squares of the components. So we don't need the negatives in, we just got 3 squared plus 8 squared plus the 1 squared. And this comes out at root 74. And because it's a length, I'm just going to write units there, okay? Root 74 units is that shortest distance. Now it's worthwhile just mentioning at this point, let's just put a note here, that you might be asked to find the coordinates of P or the position vector of P. And that's going to be easy because all we need to do is substitute lambda equals 2 into here. So if we're going for the position vector of P, that will be O to P. And substituting lambda equals 2 in here, you can see that we've got 4i minus 4i, so that's no i's. And then for the j's, we end up with minus 6j. And for the k terms, we've got plus 3k. If you're asked to find the coordinates of P, then the coordinates of P will be 0, minus 6, and 3. So I hope that's given you some idea anyway how we can go about finding the shortest distance then of a point from a line.